Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Samvedana. Today in this video I am going to explain about the enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, a technique which involves the protein-protein interactions. So now let us start. What is ELISA? ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, which is a commonly used analytical biochemical assay first described by Engwall and Perlman in 1971. ELISA has been used as a diagnostic tool in medicine, plant pathology, biotechnology and for quality control check in various industries. What is the basic principle behind this ELISA? The basic principle is the amount of antigen, that is the protein of our interest to detect, present is proportional to the amount of enzyme labeled specific antibody. The labeled enzyme that catalytically act on the chromogenic or fluorogenic substrates and the final intensity of the color or fluorescent product is proportional to the amount of enzyme trapped. There are different types of ELISA. One is direct ELISA and second indirect ELISA. In direct ELISA, there are two types. First one is the DAS ELISA, that is double antibody sandwich ELISA, and second, direct antigen coated enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. In indirect ELISA, there are three types. First one is double antibody sandwich ELISA. In this, there are two types, two species assay and FAP2 assay. Second one is DAC ELISA. Under this, generally we will use plate trapped ELISA, that is PTA ELISA. And third one, PAS ELISA, that is protein A sandwiched ELISA. What is the difference between this direct and indirect ELISA? In direct ELISA, what we will do is antigen detection is with the help of labeled enzyme specific antibody, that is antivirus IgG, which is enzyme labeled. Here we have to prepare conjugate for every virus. Whereas in indirect ELISA, the virus-specific antibody is not enzyme-labeled and is used as an intermediate, which in turn is detected by anti-species IgG enzyme-labeled, that is universal conjugate. Universal conjugate can be used for any detection purpose. Here we can see the clear-cut difference between direct ELISA and indirect ELISA. In direct ELISA, the antigen is detected by the primary antibody which is conjugated, whereas in indirect ELISA, antigen is bind to the specific antibody, whereas specific primary antibody is bind by the secondary antibody which is conjugated. After adding the substrate, then it will give the color reaction. Based on that color reaction, we can present our interest of the protein, whether it is present or not. Let us see the different steps involved in double antibody sandwich ELISA. First step is coating of the ELISA plate with a specific antibody called trapping antibody or capture antibody. After addition of capture antibody, we have to load the antigen, that is the protein of interest what we wanted to detect. After addition of antigen, we have to add the enzyme labeled specific antibody called detecting antibody. Then enzyme substrate addition and hydrolysis of substrate will be measured by taking optical density. Here amount of hydrolysis is proportional to amount of antigen present in the given sample. Here in this picture I showed the indirect double antibody sandwich ELISA, but here steps are the direct double antibody sandwich ELISA. In indirect double antibody sandwich ELISA, first we have to add the capture antibody, then loading of the antigen which we have to detect that antigen after addition, then we have to add the primary antibody which is not enzyme labeled, then primary antibody addition, then we have to add the secondary antibody which is enzyme conjugated. After addition of secondary body, we have to add the substrate for giving the color reaction by acting of the enzyme on that substrate. Based on the color reaction, we can detect the presence of our protein interest. Generally, in the ELISA, we will use two types of substrates. First one is the PNPP, that is p-nitrophenyl phosphate. When we are using the enzyme that is alkaline phosphatase labeled secondary antibody, when we are using this PNPP tablets, then it will give the yellow colored product which absorbs maximum light at 405 nanometer. That is, we are taking the reading at optical density at 405 nanometer. When we are using the horseradish peroxidase HRP labeled secondary antibody, then we have to add the substrate TMB, that is tetramethylbenzidine, where we have to take the optical density at 450 nanometer, which gives the blue color reaction. In this video, I explained about the enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay and its variants, that is direct ELISA and indirect ELISA, and variants among the direct and indirect ELISA, and the different steps involved in double antibody sandwich ELISA. Thank you for your keen interest in this video, and remember to like and subscribe for more videos. I wish you great success, health, prosperity and happiness. Thank you.